Earlier we looked at digital tags. Now, digital tags are those tags that are storing discrete values, like you see right here. Program, program auto, cascade. These are actually different modes in a controller. So they take a certain finite number of modes, I think 5 in this case. And what we're doing is really just storing this in the PyArchive as a series of integers, and we map that series of integers to this digital state set. So let's look at this in its totality here. So we've got, here's what it looks like when you're actually looking at the data. These are the values. These are the values here. These are the timestamps here. Now, if we switch over to the point builder and we take a look at this tag, CDM158, we can see that is a digital tag, and it is mapped to a digital state set called modes. So if we jump over to our digital state table, we can, you know, solve the mystery here by finding modes. As you can see, modes is this list of digital tags. So these are the actual values we're writing into the archive, and this is what we end up showing. And in this case, we're showing 5. Now, here's another example where we're just showing 2. This is a tag that simply takes 2 states, active versus inactive. And you can imagine a lot of these, on, off, open, close. Sometimes people tend to think that they're binary, but they're not really binary. They're just digital states. They're just a finite set, discrete values, I should say. So that's an example of another digital state set. I think that's this one right here, batch act. You see 0 is inactive, 1 is active. Now, you can do multiple Py tags associated with the same digital state set. So for example, let's say I create a brand new state set, and this set, let's measure this as a valve position. Or let's call this one valve position. This would be either open or closed. So I'm creating a new state set. I'll go over here and I'll say, well, 0 is usually closed, right? And 1 is probably open. And then for good measure, this, you may get something like this, failed or bad status or something like that, that comes from the control system. In any case, that would be an example of something I'd probably use on more than one Py tag. Multiple Py tags that all need to represent either open or closed, or closed or open. And you can imagine the same thing for on, off, and other things like that. Now, the digital states that you type in here, they're going to be case insensitive, but they are case preserving. And what we mean by that is, see, that when we create one of these state sets here, we're not really, I'm not really creating a state set that's all standalone by itself. Valve position is making reference to these digital states, but those digital states are actually stored in a common pool. And so you would imagine that you probably have more than one digital state set that requires the word closed, open, failed, etc. And for that reason, we don't generate new digital states every time we have a new state set. No, we will map any new states to any existing states that are in any other digital state set. And because this is case insensitive, as long as you type it the same way, you know, regardless of case, as long as it's got the same spelling, we will map to an existing digital state set. Now, it's case insensitive, but it's case preserving. Now, this leads to a very annoying little what do we call it? Artifact of the design. If you were to create a brand new digital state set that made reference, let me go ahead and save that, that made reference to an existing state, it would actually go ahead and preserve whatever original case was entered. Let me describe this. Let's say we've got a new, we have a different modes state set. I'm going to call modes Acme, because I'm getting some new equipment from a vendor called, you know, Acme Instrumentation. And in their world, first of all, they use all capitals for everything. So instead of having manual, uppercase, lowercase, they would just do this, manual, and let's say auto, and then they've got another one called Acme Auto. They've got some kind of a special algorithm they use for automatic PID control, so they call it Acme Auto, right? And then maybe failed. So this might be the 4 digital states that are associated with this modes Acme. Now watch what happens when I save this, and then come back and look at it again. Notice what happened? We were case insensitive because we found manual auto and failed. We found those as existing states. Now, this was not an existing state, so that one we created new. So this is kind of the, the end result of when you're case insensitive but case preserving. You end up with one of these little annoying things that kind of puzzle people. They say, hold on a second, why is this uppercase and these are lowercase? Why is the case different? So if you want to save yourself some your users some confusion, come up with a good naming convention, either, you know, all uppercase or upper lowercase or all lowercase, whatever you want, and just stick to it as you create these different modes. See, modes over here already has a manual on an auto, and we're case insensitive when we create a new one, but it's going to preserve the original case. So in this case, we did it initially as an uppercase, and that's going to stay there. Now, there actually are ways of getting around that. If it's really annoying, call tech support. We've got some mechanisms you can run from the DOS prompt that will allow you to make changes to that. Anyway, so that's what we mean by case insensitive and case preserving. Now, we mentioned this once before, but let's look at it again. The digital state set that we ship with the system is called, it's called system. Big surprise. This is something we recommend that you don't modify because we put all kinds of unusual things in there that are for user or for the internal system only. And it starts at state number 193. If you've ever wondered why we start at 193, it just goes back to the original version of Pi. And we're preserving this to make sure nobody loses their history. But anyway, so the system digital state are those things that are, you know, things that happen typically that are a problem that we would like to make some kind of note of. You know, coercion failed, interface shutdown. Let's see some of the other things. These are some of our SQC alarms states. Some of them are not currently used. Again, we recommend you do not make use of those. These are reserved for OSI's use. Let's see if there's anything else. You know, things like scan on and scan off, which some of our interfaces will write if there's an error, if there's been a filtered value, or if a calculation's been turned off. So you get the picture. This is just those things that we require to kind of keep track of what's been going on in the system. So please don't make changes to that. Now, one last point, and it's a very obscure point, so you know, unless you're really into obscurities, you can stop the video right now. But let me show you another interesting artifact of the design. If you have a Pi tag that has existing history like this, and you were going to go in and make changes to the digital state set that this is based on, that this is pointing to. See, this is pointing to the digital state set called modes, right? If we look at this tag, we're pointing to modes. Well, what happens if you go in there and you change modes so that instead of saying auto, you say, auto. And I go ahead and make that change. Well, what you'll notice is that once you refresh your screen or look at it in Process Book, you've actually changed your history. Now, everything that used to say auto now says auto. Not a big deal, just something you should be aware of. Let's say you've got a whole set of history here in which you simply got it wrong. You had active in the place of inactive and vice versa. So you would actually swap this. Maybe in this case, zero was active and one was inactive and you got that wrong initially. Well, the great news about that is if you go back into the digital state set, you make that change right here and it will immediately switch for all your existing history. If I switch this with active and this for inactive, then great, you've solved your problem. But what if you simply have a new set of states that you'd like to use and you want to preserve what was there originally? So if you want to preserve the original history, then what you'll have to do is go into the digital state set table, create a new digital state set, and then associate that new digital state set with this tag. So in other words, you're going to substitute your modes ACME or whatever, you know, whatever your new modes are. Let me give you an example. Let me just demonstrate. And this is why I said skip this if you're not interested, because it's kind of obscure. Let's say, again, I've got a new digital state set, and I want to preserve my original history, but have new modes from this point forward. So I'll call this one modes number 2. So I'll go ahead and save the changes there. So with modes number 2, let's say we've got, let's get some fake modes here. Okay, so here's some brand new modes for mode number two. I'll go ahead and save these. Now watch what happens if I go into the point builder for that existing tag, and now I point this to modes two instead. Watch what happens to the history. What we're doing is we're actually generating a new record in the historian that associates whatever the original modes was at the time that original data was collected. So if I go over now to my archive editor, we take a look at, let's just go back to the last 2 hours. Now you'll see we did not make changes to those modes. Those modes are still good, or those modes are still reflected as they were historically. But as you can see now, I'm associating a new set of digital states with those integers that are being stored internally. Let me refresh this, see if we can find more. Yeah, see now, and now I've got a brand new set of digital states that are associated with that, yet I've preserved the history of it. Kind of obscure, but if you have a need for that, that's how you would do it.